So, next gland in the endocrine system is the parathyroid gland. So, parathyroid gland again is a gland which is just behind the thyroid gland. So, these glands are very small, they are located below the thyroid gland. So, anatomy and histology, all those we are not going to deal, we are going to deal about only the disorders of parathyroid gland. This again we have hyperfunctioning of the gland is called as hyperparathyroidism, hyperfunctioning of the gland is called as hypothyroidism, then we have a parathyroid tumors, then we have some syndromes called as Menn syndrome. So hyperparathyroidism is an overactivity of one or more of the parathyroid gland resulting in overproduction of the parathormone, the hormone secreted by the parathyroid gland. Overproduction of parathormone is characterized by bone decalcification. So when there is a hyperparathyroidism, more parathormone will destroy the bone and developmental of renal calculi, kidney stones containing calcium. So there are three main types of hyperparathyroidism. One is called as primary hyperparathyroidism, secondary hyperparathyroidism and tertiary. In primary, what will happen? The problem lies in the parathyroid gland itself. Secondary and tertiary, that means that another disease in the body has caused the parathyroid gland to be overactive. Secondary, there is a signal to the gland to produce more parathyroid hormone, for example, low vitamin B12. So, in the secondary, parathyroid gland is absolutely normal, but there is some signal which is sending to the gland to produce more parathormone. That signal is in the form of low vitamin D. Then tertiary hyperparathyroidism, the glands continues to oversecrete parathyroid hormone even though the signal is gone. These conditions may be seen in some kidney diseases. So in the majority of cases, the cause of hyperparathyroidism is not known. In most people, hyperparathyroidism occurs sporadically. In some cases, however, there can be a genetic basis for this disorder. A rare inherited syndrome called familial multiple endocrine neoplasia type 1 is associated with hyperparathyroidism. In some cases, all of the four thyroid glands are somewhat enlarged and secrete excessive amounts of hormone. And the clinical manifestation of hyperparathyroidism is mainly it affects the GIT, kidney, psychic status and bone. So excessive calcium may cause high blood pressure or hypertension. Symptoms often described as moans, stones, groans and bones. So these are the characteristics manifestation of hyperparathyroidism. Moans means gastrointestinal conditions like constipation, nausea, vomiting, decreased appetite, abdominal pain, peptic ulcers, frequent hard ones. Then stones is kidney related stones due to excessive mobilization of calcium from the bone. Then groans is nothing but psychological disturbance in the form of confusion, dementia, memory loss, depression, personality changes. Then bones is bone pain and bone related conditions like bone aches and pains, fractures, curving of the spine and loss of height, flank pain and urgent uriation. So moans, stones, groans and bones are the clinical manifestation of hyperparathyroidism. So diagnostic blood test, calcium level in the blood are elevated and the blood PTH levels are also inappropriately high for the serum calcium. X-ray of the bone structure may reveal fractures and other changes in the bone. Then bone mineral density, dual energy X-ray absorptiometry, sometimes called as a DEXA scan, uses low dose X-ray to measure bone marrow density, it will be decreased. CT, USG, urine collection, vitamin B12, these tests is recommended because vitamin deficiency is common in people with primary hyperparathyroidism. So treatment is drug therapy can include medication that inhibit bone resorption such as a bisphosphonates, estrogen, progesterone, vitamin D analogs. Thiazide, a specific type of diuretic that may prescribe for patients with high calcium levels, and physical inactivity, vitamin D and calcium intake should be coupled with monitoring disease progression such as a serum calcium, creatinine and bone density. Surgical management, remove the renal stone, osteoporosis treat, parathyroidectomy can also be helpful. The next is hypoparathyroidism, uncommon condition in which body secretes abnormally low level of parathormone. P PTH is a key to regulate and maintain the balance of body's level of two minerals, that is calcium and phosphorus. It is very, very important to maintain the calcium and phosphorus levels in balance. The low production of PTH in hypoparathyroidism leads to abnormal low calcium levels in the blood and bone and to increase the phosphorus in blood. So risk factor for the hypoparathyroidism is recent neck surgery, particularly if thyroid was involved, the parathyroid will be removed, family history of hypoparathyroidism, some autoimmune disorders or endocrine conditions like Addison's disease, that is hypofunctioning of the adrenal gland, which causes the adrenal gland to produce too little of its hormones. So post-surgical hypoparathyroidism, autoimmune disease, hereditary hypoparathyroidism, extensive cancer, radiation treatment of the face or neck, low levels of magnesium in the blood. So clinical manifestation, tingling or burning paresthesias in fingertips, toes and lips, muscle aches, cramps in leg, feet, abdomen and face, twitching or spasm of muscles, particularly around the mouth, fatigue, painful menstruation, patchy hair loss, dry coarse skin, brittle nails, depression, anxiety, all these are seen in hypoparathyroidism. Again, in diagnosis, you ask the history, physical examination, blood test. In blood test, you see low blood calcium level, low parathormone level, high phosphorus level, low magnesium level. So treatment is due oral calcium carbonate tablets, vitamin D and parathormone tablets. So diet should be rich in calcium, low in phosphorus, intravenous infusion, monitoring of all the tests can be done. The next comes to the parathyroid tumors. Parathyroid tumor is same like other tumors like pituitary adenoma, adrenal adenoma. Parathyroid adenoma is the most common tumor of the parathyroid gland. It can occur at any age and sex, but found more frequently in adult. These adenomas are first brought to attention because of excessive secretion of parathormone resulting in hyperparathyroidism. Grossly, again, the parathyroid adenoma is small, less than 5 cm in diameter, encapsulated yellow brown, ovoid nodule weighing up to 5 gram or more. Major clinical manifestation of hyperparathyroidism are seen, that is groans, stones, mounds and bones. Majority of adenomas are composed microscopically of chief cells arranged in sheaths or cords. Auxiliary cells and water clear cells may be found intermingled in varying proportions. Usually a rim of normal parathyroid parenchyma and fat are present external to the capsule, which helps in distinguishing adenoma from the diffuse hyperplasia of the parathyroid gland. So again, parathyroid adenoma is most common. Parathyroid carcinoma is less common. Again, the carcinoma shows microscopically, carcinoma tends to be irregular in shape. Microscopically, it shows local invasion to the adjacent tissue and distant metastasis is a helpful criterion such type of malignancies. Then we have other syndrome called as Menn syndrome. There is multiple endocrine neoplasia syndrome. In men, we have two types, Menn 1 and Menn 2. In Menn 2, we have 2A and 2B. In Menn 1, it is nothing but group of disorders. In Menn 1 is called as Wormer syndrome, in which we have parathyroid tumors leads to hyperparathyroidism, pituitary tumors leads to hyperpituitarism, pancreas tumors leads to excessive secretion of insulin, that is hypoglycemia will be there. So in Wormer syndrome, parathyroid tumor, pituitary tumor and the pancreas tumor, PPP. Then Menn 2A is called as Sippel syndrome. In Sippel syndrome, along with the parathyroid tumors, we have thyroid tumors, medullary carcinoma of the thyroid, which is arising from the parafollicular C cells, and the pheochromocytoma. Pheochromocytoma is a benign tumor of the adrenal gland, which is arising from the medulla of the adrenal gland. So in Menn 2B, two things are same. Medullary carcinoma of thyroid and pheochromocytoma are present. Plus, third one, they have ganglioneuroma, that is the nerve tumors are also present in Menn 2B. So this is the Menn 1 and Menn 2. In Menn 1, we have pancreas, pituitary and parathyroid. Parathyroid is common for both. In Menn 2, what we have pheochromocytoma and medullary thyroid carcinoma is common. If parathyroid involvement is there, then it is 2A. If the neuromas, nerves are involved, it is 2B. So parathyroid is seen in Menn 1 and Menn 2A. इन टाइप वन इट लीड्स टू पैराथायरॉइड हाइपर पैराथायरॉइडिज्म हाइपरकैल्सीमिया जी बिकॉज ऑफ जी इन्वॉल्वमेंट पेशेंट विल हैव जोलिंगर-एल्सन सिंड्रोम्स एंड बिकॉज ऑफ पिट्यूटरी इन्वॉल्वमेंट पेशेंट विल हैव एक्रोमेगैली कुशिंग सिंड्रोम गैलेक्टोरिया बट इज मेंट टू ए बिकॉज ऑफ पैराथायरॉइड इन्वॉल्वमेंट पेशेंट विल हैव हाइपर पैराथायरॉइडिज्म हाइपरकैल्सीमिया मेडुलरी कार्सिनोमा ऑफ द थायरॉयड एंड फियोक्रोमोसाइटोमा फियोक्रोमोसाइटोमा विल लीड टू इंक्रीज कैटेकोलेमाइन Whereas type 2B has a mucosal neuromas, it is mucosal nodules, morphonoid habitus, medullary carcinoma of the thyroid, increased calcitonin and increased catecholamine. So these men syndromes are very very important exam question of you. These are syndromic complexes having divided into men 1 and 2 and 2A, 2B. What are the tumors or what are the organs involved in these things and their consequences. Thank you. We'll stop here. Here we have completed your endocrine system, that is the thyroid, parathyroid, pituitary and the adrenal glands.